Hello Cloud Gurus and welcome back to another AWS This Week, where we take a look at what amazing things AWS have just announced. This week, Amazon S3 gets a storage lens, CloudFormation gets modules, and Amazon Translate gets a bunch of new languages. All this, plus we announce our Guru of the Week and some special breaking news. It's AWS This Week with me, Nick Triantafillou. Kicking it off this week, AWS have announced Amazon S3 Storage Lens, a service which gives you organization-wide visibility into your S3 buckets, where you can see your storage usage and trends, receive recommendations to improve cost efficiency, and apply security best practices. It's the first cloud storage analytics solution which will provide a single view of your object storage across all of your accounts. You can even export your metrics in CSV or Parquet format for further analysis with tools like Amazon Athena, QuickSight, and Redshift. It looks like a really useful service. Next up, this week we received the announcement that AWS CloudFormation now has modules. Modules allow you to define your infrastructure and applications with reusable building blocks. A module encapsulates one or more resources and their configurations for reuse across your organization. This lets you define and provision infrastructure in a repeatable and consistent way. It makes it easier to use the resources you need while staying aligned with best practices. Experts from AWS, AWS partners, and the open source community will no doubt build a collection of reusable modules for the world to use, and they're fully integrated with the CloudFormation registry as well. Modules are available right now in various regions, so check out the resource link below to see if yours is one of them. This week, Amazon also announced that Amazon Translate, the fully managed neural machine translation service, has added support for 16 new languages, and this brings it to a total of 71 languages with 4,970 translation combinations. That's huge. The newly available languages are Armenian, Catalan, Gujarati, Haitian, Icelandic, Canada, Kazakh, Lithuanian, Malayalam, Macedonian, Maltese, Mongolian, Sinhala, Telugu, Uzbek, and Welsh. Amazon Translate lets you reach a wider audience and can assist with content localization, communication, and text analytics of content in multiple languages. Now we have some breaking news that I've just learned about. AWS have announced that they are adding exam lab components to their certification exams. Starting with the new AWS Certified SysOps Administrator Associate exam, they will have a scenario that is composed of a set of tasks to perform in the AWS Management Console or the AWS command line interface during the exam. I can't tell you how excited I am for this, as it gives everyone a chance to prove their skills during their exams. Now, before we get to Guru of the Week, don't forget that reInvent 2020 kicks off next week. It's free and virtual this year, so go and register at the link below. A-Cloud Guru will have a booth and you'll be able to visit it each day for some exciting goodies. Don't forget to also follow our Twitter feed for the latest updates as well, and we'll be covering all of the highlights from the 3 weeks of reInvent right here on AWS This Week, so don't forget to tune in. Okay, onto our Guru of the Week. This week, our winner is Kiran Chand, a solutions architect at Alamy in India. Congratulations, a t-shirt and sticker pack are on their way to you now. If you'd like to enter Guru of the Week, please check out our forum link below. Okay, that's all for me this week. Keeping awesome, Cloud Gurus, and we'll see you next time.